Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan. I have been a developer for over 20 years. I focus on DevOps and security in the cloud. Today I'll demo add a Docker container health check in two ways. After you finish the video, you're able to understand why Docker container need a health check, how to add Docker container built-in health check, and how to use Docker run command to override container built-in health check. The video related markdown and exercise files are in my GitLab and GitHub. The links are below. In this video, we'll cover why does Docker container need health check, how to add a health check to Docker container, and two hands-on demos. Create container built-in health check. Use Docker run command to override container built-in health check. Let's start. First topic, why does Docker container need health check? You build your Docker image pushed into a repository and start a new container in production environment. Everything's working and you go home, but you'll meet with the outage report when you come back to the office next morning. Your container's still running, but it not process any request. This scenario may be uncomfortable to operation teams that work with Docker. So we use Docker health check feature to get real-time monitor data availability of your containers. Also, the data will consumed by monitoring tool such as permissions, app dynamics, and Datadog, etc. Next topic, I'll introduce how to add a health check to Docker container. Docker uses the command's exit code to determine the container is healthy or not. If the health check value is zero, that means container is healthy. The container works normally. If the health check value is one, that means container unhealthy. The container workload may not be functioning. Docker uses value two as reserved status. Health check has four options. Interval, set the time between health check. Start period, set the duration after container start when the health check should be ignored. Restricts, this lets you request a multiple field before the container make as unhealthy. Timeout, set the timeout of health check commands. Docker will treat the check as field if the command do not get response in this time frame. The default values is for built-in health check only. There are two ways to add the health check container. Let me move down. Add health check section in Dockerfile as container built-in health check. Or use Docker run command to add the health check on fly. I'll show the detail in my hands-on demo. First, my hands-on demo is container built-in health check. Three pre-requests for my demo. First, the curl command is available in the demo container. The curl command is installed by apt-get in Dockerfile. Also, my Spring Boot demo app has health check endpoints. The video, how to add health check API to Spring Boot microservice, has a detail. The link is below. Another pre-request is Docker environment. I created the videos how to install Docker in different operation system. All the video links are below, such as install Docker in Windows 10, Windows 11, in Oracle Linux 8, and Oracle Linux 9. This example. The example is from my demo Docker file. The health check function has two lines. First line, health check plus parameters. 204 parameters are used. Interval value is 30 seconds. Timeout value is 3 seconds. The second line uses curl as health check command. Curl hyphen f space health check API endpoint. Exit value is 1. The logic is if the curl accepts the API endpoints without any error, return value is 0. If the curl command with any errors, return value is 1. If you want to no health check more deeply. The health check link point Dockerfile health check official document. After we know the knowledge of building health check, copy and paste, run the command in PowerShell. First command, docker run, container name is health check test, run in background, docker image is lianduan training select sprintboot demo, tag is v11. The video, how to enable and search AWS ECS Fargate log of the docker image, has a detail the docker image function. Run the command. The docker container is running. Run command docker ps to check the health status. In the result, the status is starting. Run command again. You see the status change from starting to healthy. And then run command docker inspect to render the health check history. Move a little bit up, give more space of the command. The status is healthy. Also, there are health check history in the below. Next, let me run the docker rm space hyphen f plus container name to stop and remove the container. Next hands-on demo, use docker run command with health check parameters to override the container building health check. Switch back to the markdown file. Move down to next topic. Docker run command override the container building health check. The pre-requests are same as above demo, so skip them. Docker run command health check has two types, create health check and override container building health check. My demo is the second type, override container building health check. Please remember, the two types of commands are same. Docker will be automatically detect the type. If the container has built-in health check, the type is override. If not, the type is create. The link is docker run command health check reference. There are five parameters for the command health check. Health command, health interval, health restricts, health start period, health timeout. The five parameters same as built-in health check, no difference. Move a little bit down, get the content more space. Copy and paste the command. Open the PowerShell. Execute the docker run command. Container name is health check. Running background. Health check command is curl-f. You see the health check endpoint is changed. I highlighted the difference. Building health check endpoint is health. Docker command line will override the health check endpoint to health select pin. Health check interval reduce the time from 30 seconds to 2 seconds. The same Docker image and the tag is used running the command. Container is created. Next, run Docker ps command to check the container status. The status is healthy. Clean up the screen. Run inspect command on health check test container. Use GQ to filter the health check status session. First health check time is 11 a.m. 27 minutes and 5 seconds. Second health check time is 11 a.m. 27 and 7 seconds. The interval is 2 seconds. That means override health check successfully. All topics are completed. Today we learned how to add a container health check and why we need to do it. If something not clear in the video, please post comment in below. I'll try to answer. Thank you and see you in the next video.